Okay, we're gonna do a little, I guess, first impression, sort of mini review on the Hultafors Classic. This is the Trekking Axe Mini. It has the 500 gram head on it. Comes in this little box here, and there's the booklet with it. Let's go over that a little bit. And it's tied onto the handle. It's hand forged since 1697. I think they're the oldest axe manufacturer in Sweden, I guess. This one's actually in English. A lot of other reviews I saw, everything was in Swedish in here, which is kind of weird why they would mail stuff out. Unless it was, I don't know, kind of weird. A lot of the people that were reviewers that were like in England or someplace, they had ended up with Swedish booklets. And it just goes on sort of the story and how great their axes are and everything. Let's see, there's the hand forged and everything. And the thing about how the way the edge should be, and how to replace the handle if you have to, and if you can carry your axe, and all this good stuff. So, that's pretty cool. Anyway, some good information in there. So I've been using this a little bit of light splitting, carving. If anybody's interested, I might do a video showing some of that stuff, but I'll just tell you, it works really good. It holds an edge well. It's nice little, the size of it's good for what I want it for, and just sort of an axe to carry around the woods with me and stuff like this, and it's big enough to get quite a lot of stuff done, but small enough you can carry it. Like, you don't even hardly know you have it. And but you can sort of use it like a knife because it's so small, and the way the handles, or the way the head is shaped and stuff, you can choke up on it. Because, you know, like a good hunting knife is good, but they're not an axe. Like, a lot of people, they have these weird knives that some people carry. They think they can use them as an axe. So, like, it's easier to spare to have a small axe like this and a knife as well. You can do all kinds of stuff with them. So, anyway, the cover here is really, really good. This one's better than the other Swedish axes, in my opinion. Covers the blade here, and it covers the back, and has a leather strap that goes around, and you pull it tight, and then there's also this little ring here. You push that down, and it'll lock it on, so it doesn't come out. And you get your belt loop on the back here. So just pull that out and slip it off. And there's really nice leather. It looks like they put some neat sort of oil or something into it. It's all riveted together nice and everything. I try to act like a professional axe reviewer here. But they put the little piece of leather in there in the middle for the rivets to go through. And I guess that keeps the rivets away from the blade. But these are, I guess they're brass. I don't know. But it's just, you don't want like steel rivets because they touch the blade. I don't know. That's what everyone else says. That's all the other reviewers say. So, go through the motions here, I guess. But it's a nice cover anyway. Here's your little axe. It says made in Sweden. 0.5, so it's 500 gram head. And the one, I don't know if that's pounds. Because it, like, 500 grams is like 1.1 pounds, I guess. So it's a nice light head and everything, but it's, you know, heavy enough you can do a little bit of stuff. You know, it's not for chopping down giant trees or anything, but for most kind of stuff you gotta do in the woods, it's fine. And it's got a hickory handle, nice, really nice shape to it. I prefer the size of this. Like that little hatchet I have, it's got a real small little handle, and I don't like that as much. It's got a nice handful here. Let me go through some of the stuff, I guess, that people think is important. The way the grain is good. It's supposed to be going this way, I guess, because if it's going sort of this way, theoretically this can bust off or weakens this just because the grain is going here. So I guess that's the thing. But then you, some people, they, I can see that being an issue, but some people they say, well, I had ones that grain going this way for years and it didn't break. But not into abusing tools anyway, though. So it should be all right. Another concern that I've heard other people say is that sometimes the heads, they don't consider them pushed on far enough. Like, a lot of people like to have the head down farther against this ledge here. But when I got it, you can see there was wood being plowed ahead of it, so it's tight on the sides pretty good. But then there's other people's videos, they complained about this gap here and forward of the, in the eye of the head here. But most of this, from what I can look, it's sort of a bevel, just I guess to let the head go or the handle go in easier, and it's quite tight up above that, and same with here. But I've wailed on quite a bit of stuff with this recently, been hacking on stuff with it, and there's no, you know, the head's still really good, it's really tight and everything. So in my opinion, it doesn't seem to be an issue. But also has a couple pictures here, it shows more or less don't do this kind of deal. It has a, I'm sure we're in frame here. Yeah, I was like, oh, look what I'm looking at here, guy. Okay. You can see here, don't hit the back of the axe here with a metal hammer or sledgehammer. Because apparently if you hit it here, this is fairly thin here, it can make this open up and then the handle can get loose. So don't do that. And then the one down below, it's don't be pounding wedges with it and stuff. I guess you can do a little bit of light, you know, like a tent peg or something, but need to drive stuff, get a club of wood or something and do that. this is for cutting stuff and splitting stuff. It's not really for, you know, driving things. But as far as the wedges and stuff go, they're not too bad. I've got a wooden wedge here, and then a circular metal wedge in the middle. One sort of thing going on here, it's sort of split out on the side. I saw that on, I guess, quite a few of these. But I don't know if that's such a big deal, because these splits are just above the line here of the head, it appears. It's just the more cosmetic kind of looking things. There's also one here, and then the end of the wooden wedge here, it flaked off. So, but my opinion is not a big deal, but I don't know, for the price point, it might be sort of, some people kind of don't like that, but it doesn't really bother me a whole lot. And it's, I can't see that really affecting the usability of it, and it's not severe enough that I'd want to spend money to send it back and then get something that possibly could be worse, or I don't know. But that's, most of them are good, like that's just minor things. I don't know, people that sort of complain about that stuff, I don't know if it's, you know, you'd think for the amount of money that they cost, they probably take a little bit more time, make them look a little bit more pretty, but I don't know. As I said, looks don't get too far, as long as the thing is, stands up and the head's not flying off and everything. And, you know, they gave it an honest effort. They got that wedge in there, so I don't think it's coming apart. It's just, and wood is kind of a thing like that, where it's, you put the head on, you put a wedge in it, and wood splits sometimes. It just, and it splits weird, and it does weird crap. But you can see the wood is above the top of the head, which I like. A lot of axes, they cut it flat. This, it comes up, and then when you put the wedge into it, it kind of mushrooms out, and there's no way that's going back in there. So, and I'm pretty sure it's quite tight you know, as far as the wooden wedge and the metal wedge are, even these tiny little bits of spots here where it's you know, little lines there, I can't see that being an issue. I don't think it has enough room to do anything. But, anyway. It's a nice little axe. It holds a good edge. Chopping on all kinds of stuff. I was sort of making a wooden spoon with it. That's almost complete. That's almost, you know, that's almost friggin' done, guys. Look. But, I shaped it all. It's made of a piece of firewood. Shaped it everything with this axe here. And this is ash or something. I guess this isn't softwood. And, you know, it was a bigger, it was probably a piece of wood about that big when I started. So I just got to more or less, I might thin this down to about, I don't know, half, and then, I've never done this before, so it's kind of like a learning thing, I don't know. I'm going to shape this some more. I ordered a hook knife, a Mora one, to scoop this out, or that's the fucking plan anyway. But, so I think I'm pretty sure I got it shaped about as far as I can with the axe here. But you can do some pretty fine work. It doesn't look like fine work. It looks like Russian fine work there. But you can, you know, you can chop regular, like normal axe, or you can choke up on it and sort of use it like a knife. And, so, yeah, anyway. Enough about my disgusting looking spoon. And it's not really a giant axe. Like, here's basically the same length as this, well, it's supposed to be a Mora 2000, but it's the Chinese equivalent, or sort of approximation, I guess. You can see, like, that's about the same length overall of the things. That's about, let's see, 9.5 inches from the bottom of the handle to the head here, and it's about 7.5 inches handle, and if anybody cares, I don't know, it's about 5 1/4 inches. And these are American inches here, so don't get them confused with imperial inches. So, but, okay, the camera shut off for some reason. Must be 10 minutes. For some reason, it goes 10 minutes and it turns off. I think it's tired of me talking, I guess. It's my biggest fan. But, yeah, so that's most stuff I can just blab on about. Maybe mention the profile of the blade. It's nice, thin blade. It's good chopper. It, like, you know, it doesn't have a whole lot of weight, so it doesn't really dig into wood as you know, but that's, you know, you give a little, you know, however that goes, give a little, I don't know how the fuck that goes, but, in the way that the grind is, it's, has a sort of a liquid, a long taper on the edge here. It's not super awesome, it's pretty good on this side, and then this one, it's a little bit, not so much on that side, but it still comes to a pretty decent edge. The head seems really decent steel. It's hand forging, so it's kind of has a weird kind of look to it, but that's fine. I like that kind of, and I like this, the shape of head and this little part that sticks down here. And, but yeah, it's not so like wedgy shaped or whatever. It's fairly thin. So yeah, it does bite in good for when you're, you know, hacking stuff down in the woods and things. So in my opinion, it's, you know, they're probably a tiny bit more expensive than they really ought to be, I guess. I don't know. But they're, I guess it's sort of this thing where everybody that's into axes and bushcraft and all that foolishness, they drive the prices up on everything. It's just like buying surplus guns in the old days. They were cheap and it was But now everybody starts thinking that, I don't know, it's, I think the internet caused this or something, I don't know. It just, like, it seems the prices on all that stuff just going through the roof. For no apparent reason. But, there's probably all kinds of other axes that are way cheaper, but this one, it's, this size of axe is sort of decent steel, and you can probably, guarantee there's good steel in it and everything, nice handle and everything, so it's, whatever. You'll have it, like, a lifetime, so. The one thing about the handle, it came pretty much raw, so I put a little bit of linseed oil on it. I was thinking pine tar, but linseed is good enough for now, I guess. I put a little bit in the end here, and it seemed to soak it up pretty good. So, a little bit around here. You can see where they whittled on it to get the head on originally. So you can see they did that by hand. It's like they were whittling on it with a knife or something. So anyway, that's my review, I guess, for what it's worth. But it's a pretty decent axe, I think. So if you're, maybe that helps out somebody that can make the, thinking on buying one or whatever. Give you a little idea what you're getting into, I guess.